shut the light, shut the shade. You.
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
Hi, boss. What are you doing here this time of day? You usually let Alfredo handle the lunch crowd.
I do. But I've got something special cooking.
Oh, really? Something I should know about?
No reason you shouldn't. Just a little meeting with Stryker Bellman.
Oh, yes, to pitch the big business deal that Alex wouldn't buy, right?
No. Look who just came in.
Well, what do you know? A visitation.
I'd better take care of this personally.
Mm-hmm. I'll take over, Alfredo.
Of course, Mr.
Alex. Good to see you again.
Hello.
Mrs. Carrington. Dennis. Right this way, and I'll show you the best table in the house. I want the whole room to see what a lovely lady you brought along.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis.
Do fine, Clipper.
Well, I hope so. After all, it's not often we get to see you twice in the same week.
I used to think that a businessman who stopped for lunch was a fool, but Iris has convinced me it's the other way around.
It's about time.
Well, if there's anything I can do for you, just holler. Have a good lunch.
Dennis, I'm glad to have this chance to really meet you and talk with you.
Boy, I never thought I'd see Alex Wheeler take time out for lunch. Usually there aren't enough hours in the workday for him.
Cliff, who's that woman on the king's right hand?
That blondish?
Mm-hmm.
Iris Carrington. The sun rises and sets on that lady for Alex.
And Dennis Carrington is her son.
Yeah.
I know Dennis. He's my sister's boyfriend. I just think I'll drop over and say hello.
With Alex Wheeler sitting there?
Sure, why not? Billionaires don't scare me, sugar. Not one little bit.
When I made the offer on Mike Marshall's house, Dennis, I made what I consider a very generous offer to help the family out.
Well, it's easy to be generous when you've just raked in all the chips. Throwing a few back doesn't hurt at all.
Dennis? Well, Dennis Carrington. I haven't seen you since you visited Dawn out at the homestead. Oh, please, please don't get up.
I see that reading the paper finally paid off for you.
Sure did. I got a job at the top of the world. Oh, I'm sorry to barge in on you like this, but I just had to meet your mother, Dennis. I've heard so much about her from Dawn.
Yeah, right. Paige, this is my mother, Iris Carrington. Mom, this is Paige Marshall, Dawn's sister.
Oh, I'm very happy to meet you, Paige.
Thank you. I must say I've been introduced a lot of different ways in a lot of shows and clubs, but I think that's the first time I've been introduced as Dawn's sister.
I'm only surprised Dennis didn't introduce me as Dawn's future mother-in-law.
Mom.
Well, you have to admit that's the way you've been behaving, as though everything and everybody revolves around Dawn Marshall.
Well, that's really not true.
Please, Dennis and Iris, let's not get into that. That's not why we're here.
Oh, I'm sorry, Paige. I didn't introduce you to Alex
Wheeler. Alex
Wheeler,
that's all right. We've already met, haven't we? When I signed Mr. Wheeler's very generous offer to buy Daddy's old house.
You accepted the offer?
Well, of course. Wouldn't any reasonable person?
Then you don't share Dawn's attitude about selling the house to Alex?
Well, Mrs. Carrington, Dawn is the baby of the family. You know, Daddy always used to coddle her. I keep hoping she'll grow up one of these days. But I think if Daddy were here, he would want us to put the past behind us. Certainly not to turn down a very kind and generous offer like Mr. Wheeler is making.
I only knew Mike Marshall a short while, but I'm sure of it.
Thank you. Well, I've interrupted your lunch much too long. I'll be running along now.
Thank you, Paige.
It was a pleasure meeting you. I'm very glad you came over.
Thank you. Bye, all.
Okay, now I've got Mrs. Marshall's signature and Paige's and Courtney's on the agreement to sell. But Justin and Don, I don't know, they look like hardcore holdouts to me.
Don't worry. Don called me up this morning. Seems like she and Justin have both changed their minds. They both want to sign.
They do? Well, I thought I'd look out your window and see an iceberg before I heard that. What happened?
Well, it's like an old professor in my law school used to say, Ryan. For a lawyer, the signatures are all. The rest is biography.
Okay, so we'll leave the reasons to the historians, right? You know, I think I'm going to learn a lot from you, Stryker.
Well, you just keep on listening, son. As long as I'm here, I'll teach you everything I know. You know, I'm going to have to assign you to a new piece of work. That about wraps this up.
No, no, not quite. There's still a problem with Ginny.
Ginny?
Mm-hmm. She refuses to clear Barrett's succession by asking for a certificate of presumed death. She feels that, well, that she'd be betraying Barrett. You know, wiping him out with a piece of paper.
You may be giving up a little too easy there. There's a way you can get off dead center if you want to try it.
What is it?
Well, under Texas law, anyone with an interest in the property can file for presumption of death. It doesn't have to be the widow.
What do you mean?
Kate. Now, she's the administratrix of Mike's estate. She's got a legal right to file. Oh, dear. You are a mite involved in this now, aren't you? Personally, not just as a lawyer.
Come on, you know I am. Oh, I keep asking myself, am I really that interested in getting Alex's house? Or do I just want Ginny to admit that Barrett's dead?
Well, doesn't matter a whit. You're doing an honest piece of lawyering here. It's the best interest of everybody involved. If it happens to bring Ginny around at the same time, that's no sin.
Hey, thanks, Trek. Couldn't ask anyone for better advice. You're a pretty regular guy, you know that?
I got me a rule.
What's
never
that?
Give the other guy a better break than you give yourself. I tell you, if the Lord wanted me to be a scapegoat, I'd have been born chewing a cud. Listen, all this talk's got me hungry. How about going and get a bite of lunch?
Oh, no thanks. I've got to head back to the ranch.
Oh, I see. And what advice are you going to be giving, counselor?
You're not going to get well if you don't eat something.
You call that stuff food? Tastes a lot like dishwater to me. Or Max is cooking, since Elena's shuffled off to your place.
Well, I thought Kate was looking after y'all.
Well, she does, some of the time. It's the other times I can't stand. Just like I can't stand that soup.
Aw, that's nonsense. It's good, strong broth. Well, it's strong broth. Well, it's broth.
You call that broth? It isn't even good dishwater. Next time you come, why don't you bring me a steak and a couple of beers? You know, you could smuggle in a 5-course meal in that purse of yours.
When you get out of here, I'm going to treat you to the biggest, thickest steak this side of Kansas City. But while you're here, do what they tell you to. Stop sulking like a little boy with the chicken pox.
Aw, Maggie.
Now, don't aw Maggie me. Nobody has got any sympathy for any big, tough deputy that goes around smashing up stock cars. Well, you near scared the family half to death.
Maggie, it's my life.
Okay. Okay, it's your life. Throw it away if you want to. But don't do it while the family is watching. Nobody wants to see your imitation of a liver sausage sandwich, all meat from edge to edge.
You're hazardous to my health, Maggie. Don't you know it hurts me to laugh like that? Hey, I'm really sorry about scaring everybody.
You know, I thought Elena was gonna come plumb unglued. She was so upset, and Terry wasn't much better.
What about Nita?
Oh, well, Nita was torn up pretty bad, too.
No? Well, how come she hasn't been to see me, then?
Well, she's been pretty busy, what with the restaurant and all, and... You want to know the truth? She wanted to come. Real bad. Only she ran into an obstacle.
What obstacle?
Billy Joe. Well, it seems like he took a real dislike to you. I overheard him say something real nasty about you.
What?
Well, he said he could understand why some people could just hate certain kinds of food because the very sight of pig made him sick to his stomach. Only his grammar wasn't quite that good.
Well, that...
Now...
He's gonna get what's coming to him. If I've ever seen anybody who was born to hang,
no,
it's that
no,
stinking
no.
Little...
Now, listen. I agree with you completely, but... Nita's married to that trash, and she's got to live with him.
Yeah, but she doesn't have to listen to him. She could come visit me if she wants to. Billy Joe can't stop her.
Yes, he can, honey. She came down this morning. She had a black eye. A real dilly.
Think that cringing little dog...
Now, Ricky, take it easy. I don't know for sure. But I'm afraid so.
Can I come in?
Elena, why don't you sing a little song for me? Come on, how am I going to introduce you to some big talent scout if I ain't heard you sing? I know you can do it. I hear you sing all the time. You think nobody's around.
I'm not in the mood, Billy Joe.
You ain't shy, are you? I mean, how are you going to get in front of a big crowd and belt out Hank Williams if you can't even sing to me?
It's not the same.
I'll tell you what. Why don't we dance, huh? That ought to put you in the mood, and then if you feel like it, you can sing to me. Sing in my ear, you know?
Okay. I love to dance.
Close the door. You don't have to worry anymore.
Hey, we'll make beautiful music together, you know? Come on, sing me some more. Come on.
I'll be yours. baby tonight. Shut the light. Shut the shade. You don't have to be afraid. I'm the baby tonight.
Oh, I didn't get to finish my song.
Hey, that's all right. There's another one coming down the pike. Anyways, that gives us more time for this.
No, Billy Joe, don't spoil it.
Spoil it? It's your big chance, darling. I mean, Nita and Maggie are at the hospital visiting that... your brother, and, well, we're here alone for the first time since you came to Houston. And, well, this is our chance. Let's grab it, huh?
No, Billy Joe, I couldn't do that.
Why not? Hey, we're just sharing a kiss and a beer. What's wrong with that, huh? What's the harm? Who's gonna know?
I would, Bill.
Hey, look, me and Nita, we got this understanding, see? I mean, she lives her life and I live mine. Okay, let's just dance. You don't want to be a big star, it's no skin off my nose.
Okay. I guess there's no harm in dancing, is there?
Sure, babe. Let's dance.
Well, I don't know about you, Dennis, but I found Paige Marshall to be an extremely sensible and down-to-earth young woman.
You're saying Dawn isn't sensible and down-to-earth?
You said that, Dennis. I didn't.
Iris, let me talk to them.
Look, you can both talk till you're blue in the face. You're not going to change my mind.
I'm sorry you feel that way. But whether I change your mind or not, I do understand the Marshalls' reactions to Mike's suicide. And I understand Dawn's reaction to Mike's suicide.
How could you possibly understand Dawn's reactions?
I understand because I felt the same myself. I've had to live with the fact that I didn't realize how desperate Mike really was.
Well, then you must have been blind.
Really, Dennis?
It's all right, Iris. I was blind. I was so obsessed by my vision that I shut out other people's dreams, their lives. And now I know that was wrong.
Yeah, well, it's a little late now, isn't it?
I hope not. And I hope I can convince you and Dawn of what Kate Marshall already knows. That I never meant to harm Mike. That I would do anything in my power to help the family out.
Then you stay out of their lives.
Dennis, Alex has made an extremely generous offer on the River Oaks house. And he's freed the ranch of all debts. I'm sure he'd be glad to help the family in any other way he can. And to help you.
Yes. If there's anything you know that I can do. If I can be of any assistance to you and Dawn and getting your lives together.
What is this? You offering me a bribe?
No.
Dennis, I'm ashamed of you. That's the most insulting thing I have ever heard.
It's pretty insulting, isn't it, Mom, to be offered a bribe? Or would you call it something else?
I'd call it a generous offer.
Your mother tells me that you're thinking about buying Western Art. I'd like to help you out.
No, thanks.
You know you can't afford to buy the gallery without help from me or from Alex. Why are you being so stubborn?
Because Dawn would spit on anything this man gave her. And she'd do the same thing to me if I accepted anything from him.
Mr. Bellman, good to see you again. Let me take you to a table myself.
Always good to see a man you'd like to sell a horse to, eh, Clipper?
Oh, well, I've got something a lot more valuable than a horse in mind, Mr. Bellman.
Alex! And Iris! And Dennis! Well, if this isn't the picture of a family group, I never did see one. You know, you could do a lot worse than have a fine young fellow like that for a son, Alex. Pity you never married. But it's never too late now, is it, Iris?
Oh, it's never too late.
Won't you sit down, Stryker?
Thanks, but Clipper's just dying to talk to me about some big business deal. I think he wants to sell me a short-winded horse with a wall eye and a spine that with a dip in it that looks like a roller coaster.
I hope we'll see you again soon, Stryker.
You can count on it, Iris. Goodbye, you all. Well, come on, Clipper. Let's sit down. Get this over with.
Look, maybe we should talk about this later on. I just don't like talking about it with Alex Wheeler sitting right over there.
Well, why not? I've never had anything I had to hide from Alex.
Yeah, well, maybe the feeling's not mutual.
Well, what are you driving at?
This deal I've got. It has to do with oil transport. For big bucks. I've got a deal that could put you and I in the chips for the rest of our lives.
Well, son, I am already in the chips. And the rest of my life could be tomorrow. If you got some big oil transport deal, why don't you just take it straight to Alex first?
It hurts me to say this, Stryker. But I know Alex better than you do. And I don't trust him. And neither should you.
All right. I'll come up to your office after lunch. But you better have some aces in that hand of yours, son. Because if you don't, I'm gonna drive you right out of the game. I'll see to that.
The next part of Texas.
Sure, come on in, Nita.
But I thought... Well, it's good to see you here, Nita. Why don't I just see if I can find a place to get rid of this soup and if they make anything vaguely resembling coffee in this place. I think we could all use a cup, maybe.
Thanks, Maggie. Billy Joe said I should come and visit Ricky.
Well, now, why don't you just sit down and have a nice little chat? I'll be back in a couple of shakes.
So how you doing, Ricky?
Oh, I'm fine, Nita. I'm a little banged up, but nothing that getting out of the hospital won't cure.
I was so happy to hear you were all right. I wanted to stay here last night at the hospital till I
heard. That's okay.
I had to get to work and get some rest and... Well, not that I slept any, worrying about you.
Hey, it's all right, I understand.
How soon will it be before they let you out of here?
Oh, sooner than they think. I'm gonna keep badgering them until they'll be glad to see me go.
You'll probably go back to the ranch.
No. Dr. Walker says Max will have me throwing feed bags over my shoulder before I'm supposed to. Takes a long time for a bruised body to heal up. I wouldn't want to bust anything open again.
No, of course not. Where will you be staying?
Oh, Terry's apartment. She lives in one of those fancy complexes. They got a swimming pool and everything. Sure would be nice to have a little company. I can't talk to the pool.
I'm sure Maggie and Elena will be by to visit you.
I was thinking about you, Nita.
No, I don't think it's a very good idea.
Why not?
Ricky, I want you to know I'm concerned about you and all, but... I'm a married woman and I don't run around.
Oh, I never thought... I'm really sorry, Nita. I don't think about you that way. I just meant I'd like to see you as a friend.
Oh, I'm the one that should be sorry. I don't know where my head's at.
And you come and see me?
Billy Joe.
Damn it! How can you listen to that? I don't understand. How can you be loyal to somebody who knocks you around like that?
Well, like what?
Come on, Nita. If that bruise were any bigger, I'd say you got kicked by a horse. But it looks just about the size of a fist to me.
No, it was...
No, don't tell me that you ran into a door. I've had plenty of calls on wife beaters. I know what it looks like.
No, Ricky, please.
Now, don't lie to me, Nita. He hit you, didn't he? Didn't he?
Well, how's the star grump of the West Wing? I've been hearing from the nurses that... Sorry, am I interrupting something?
Oh, no, not at all, Doctor. You go right ahead. I'll wait outside.
Nita!
Well, how you feeling, Rick? Any sharp pains?
This one big dull ache.
Well, when your entire body's one large bruise, what do you expect?
Yeah, I guess.
Roll over for me, will you?
Hey, Doc, did you notice that bruise on Nita's face?
I sure did. It's a beaut.
Well, how do you reckon she got it?
That's easy. Somebody slugged her. Hard.
Yeah. It's just about how I had it figured. Doc.
Yeah?
How soon do you think I'll be able to get out of here?
Really a super dancer, you know that? I haven't had this much fun since... Well, years, you know?
You're really good too, Billy Joe. Not like those boys at Marshall County High. I mean, dancing with them is like waltzing with a cow.
Well, that's what you get when you dance with a bunch of cowboys. I mean, you gotta go to the big city, you know, to get some smooth dancing. You gotta see some of the moves they make at the top of the world. Now, that's dancing.
Well, I'd love to, but Max wouldn't let me go to anything hotter than a high school dance. I mean, the chaperones don't even allow anything wilder than the bus stop.
Chaperones? You gotta be kidding. They still got those?
Well, in Marshall County, they do.
Well, honey, this ain't Marshall County. Ain't no chaperones around here. So we can kind of play hooky a little bit, and we can drink up. So, drink up. Come on.
You know that at the gym we had to sneak out to have a drink by the cars?
We got this whole bar all to ourselves now. Come on.
Okay. I'm not going to drink too much, though.
Why not?
Well, I haven't had anything to eat since I was at the hospital. And this beer is beginning to make me feel a little lightheaded.
And good. You know, I mean, that's the way it's supposed to make you feel, darling. Supposed to make you feel real relaxed. So, relax. Let old Billy Joe take care of you, darling. Get all the tension out of your shoulders here and in your neck.
Billy Joe, I think I'd better put on another record.
Sure, baby. Play something sexy, why don't you?
Coffee grounds in somebody's boot and then pour lukewarm water over it. Well, now, hi, Bart. You all finished with our speed demon from Marshall County. How's he doing?
Well, better than he has any right to be. Called a combination of good surgery and...
And a hide as thick as his head. I tell him that all the time, and he doesn't pay any attention to me.
Doc says I'm going to be out of here in a couple days.
Oh, that's good, honey. Say, how are you coming along with that property, the art gallery?
Oh, I haven't done much about it since Courtney and I went to take a look at it. I've got to go out to the ranch and ask Kate if the property's been cleared for sale.
Well, I'm sorry Courtney's not going to be joining you, but we're going to be real glad to have you there anyway. We need a good doctor in the neighborhood.
Well, I'll let you know, Maggie.
Well, I guess Nita and I better get back to the restaurant before Billy Joe drinks up all my beer.
Maggie.
Well, I don't mind if Billy Joe has a few beers as long as the restaurant is still standing when I get back. Now, you take care of yourself. Do just what Bart tells you. There's no point in having a good doctor if you don't follow his advice. And don't drink any of this coffee. It's liable to give you a relapse.
Bye. Goodbye, Maggie. Thanks for coming.
Bye, Ricky. You get well real soon, you hear me?
Bye, Nita. Thanks for coming to see me.
Nita, why don't you let me have a look at that shiner?
Oh, well, it's nothing, it really.
Looks like a pretty big nothing to me. Is it just tender? No sharp pains?
No, nothing broke.
Well, what's the other guy look like?
Other guy?
The one you had the fight with.
Oh, I didn't have a fight, Doctor. It was dark and I bumped into something. Night blindness.
Oh, well, put an ice pack on it. That'll take the swelling down.
Thank you, Doctor. I'll do that.
Anita, after I get set up, you ought to come and let me check it out. It can be dangerous, that night blindness.
Thanks, I will.
Well, I think that's a real good idea, Anita. I'll see that she does that part.
Come right in, Mr. Connor. It's good to see you. You're here to get Justin and Dawn's signatures, I expect.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, sit down. It won't take me but a minute to get them.
Mrs. Marshall, there's something I'd like to talk about before I see Justin and Dawn.
What is it? Is something wrong?
No, not exactly, but there is a problem. That is, if you want this agreement wrapped up soon.
Well, but everything was arranged. Everyone's agreed.
Well, they have, but there's a technicality in the way. It seems we have a signature missing. Barrett's.
But Barrett is missing.
I know, and presumed dead, but not by the courts. Until 7 years pass by, the law says Barrett's still alive.
Oh, I see.
A certificate of presumptive death can be issued by the Defense Department, but it has to be requested. Now, under Texas law, the person who administers the estate can file in order to clear the estate for probate.
You're asking me to do it?
No, ma'am, I'm not asking you to do it. I'm telling you that you can.
But you'd like me to do it.
Yes.
It's not just the house business, is it? You have another reason for wanting it done.
Yes, I do. I almost asked Stryker to take over for just the reason you're hinting at. I guess you know my other motive for wanting that certificate.
You're asking Jenny to admit that she's a widow, aren't you?
I'm asking her to face the truth. Mrs. Marshall, it's been 5 years. Holding on to the idea that Barrett's coming home isn't hope. It's avoiding the truth.
Has it been that long?
Yes, it has. It's time, Mrs. Marshall. There comes a point when grief turns into loneliness, and I think that Jenny's long since reached that point. Now, you must have seen that.
Yes. I've seen it. And I've seen how happy she looks when that helicopter of yours drops down on the front pasture. But have I the right?
Yes, you do have the right. The law says you do. What you have to decide is what's best for Jenny and for Steve.
How I loved Barrett. But I love the girl he married, too. Just as if she were my own. And Stevie, too. You're right. It is time. Ginny must put the past behind her. I'll go get Justin and Dawn now. You just sit down and make yourself to home.
Yes, ma'am.
And afterward, I'll tell Ginny that I mean to do what you suggested. That I mean to have Barrett declared dead.
Well, it looks as if we've said everything we can say without getting into a shouting match. Mom, it was good seeing you again.
Good seeing you.
Mr. Wheeler, thanks for the invitation to lunch. I really couldn't tell you what we had. I was so preoccupied. I'm sure it was all very expensive.
Please. Dennis, I'd like to do this more often, and I think your mother agrees. And son, I wish you'd call me Alex.
I am not your son. Don't call me that.
I'm sorry. Just a way of speaking. I love your mother so much that I feel very close to you. And I'd like you to feel the same about me.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Wheeler, but the feeling isn't mutual.
Death.
Mom, look, I came here with you because you insisted upon it, and I listened to everything.
You did what,
listen? I listened to everything. Including everything Mr. Wheeler had to say here, and none of it's made any difference.
Because
Mr. Wheeler,
so stubborn.
I'll tell you. I came here and listened to my mother because she wanted me to be here with you. And she told me that if you're going to have a close relationship, well, anyway, you can have that close relationship if you want it. That doesn't matter to me, but my life is with Dawn Marshall.
That child.
Look, Mom, and if it means us being separated, then that's the way it has to be. I'll see you later, Mr. Wheeler.
Alex?
Iris. He's got to lead his own life. You've got to let him.
I would if he were leading it, but he's not. He's being led around by the nose by that terrible girl. Somehow I have to get him free.
Iris, I don't understand why you're so determined to force Dennis and me together.
He needs a father. Someone he can look up to. I'm determined that he accept you as that. And someday he will. I promise you that.
Show you some stuff.
Oh yeah. You haven't had enough dancing.
No, not yet. I got some pretty interesting ways to pass the time, you know. Dancing's a pretty small time, you know what I mean?
Billy Joe.
That's it. Keep saying my name, Donna. You make it sound so good.
Stay tuned for the conclusion of Texas.
Cut it out, Billy Joe. You're going too fast for me. I never meant
too fast. I never saw a quicker come on, sweetie.
Billy Joe, please, you have to stop. Nita is my friend, and I don't want to hurt her.
You know what they say. What you don't know can't hurt you. And I don't intend to let her know. Do you?
No, of course not. Billy Joe, please. Billy Joe, stop it, please. I'm going to my room now.
That's what I had to buy. With those dummy cowboys, you know. That dummy cowboys from high school. This is Billy Joe Wright talking to you now. You know that? You just can't turn me on and off like that, honey. You let me in and you deliver.
No, Billy Joe, please! No! No, please! No!
Continuing story of Texas. McKenzie.
Cut it out, Billy Joe. You're going too fast. I never meant
anything. Too fast? I never saw quicker. Come on, sweetie.
No, come on, Billy Joe. Please don't. No, Billy Joe. Please. Anita's my friend. I can't hurt her.
You know what they say. What you don't know can't hurt you. I don't intend to let her know, do you? Huh?
No, of course not. But Billy Joe, please! Billy Joe, please don't! Please don't! I'm going to my room now.
That's just what I had in mind.
No, Billy Joe! Joe! No! Billy Joe!
Come on here! What do you think? think you're dealing with? Those dumb cowboys in high school? That's Billy Joe you're talking to, see? You can't just turn me on. You can't turn me on and off like that. You let me on. Girl, now you deliver.
No, Billy Joe! No, Billy Joe! No! No! Billy Joe! No!
There's nothing dragging me back to Houston, but if you insist on Justin.
Huh?
Goodness, is that the rifle that...
That killed my daddy? It's been in my family for about a century. My great-granddaddy used it to put food on the table. Bear. And deer. It's also been used against people. Back when bands of scavengers were still preying on homesteaders. Some of them thought they could take our land away from us. They didn't. That's who's buried over there by the west fence, in case you ever wondered. And it killed a man it wasn't supposed to kill. Somebody it was meant to defend.
Honey, if I were you, I just get rid of the thing. All those awful memories.
This? Oh, no, no. Not this. This is mine. I'm taking it with me.
Can't you just visit it here? Why do you have to bring it into town?
Because that's where I'm going to live. I'm bringing everything with me. Houston is going to be my town from now on. No more Paris. No more Rome. I've come back to my town. This is my legacy. It's all I have left.
Honey, every time I see that old gun, it makes me feel all anxious inside, like it's some terrible prophecy.
Making prophecy is for prophets. This is only wood and steel and...
Hey, Justin, you in there?
I'm over here, friend. Brass. It's only a tool.
Kate's looking for you. That lawyer, Ryan Connor, is up at the house with you. He's got some papers with him. Something about, selling your dad's place in town.
Needs my name, huh?
Yeah. I think he needs you to sign him. Did I find you, Jess?
You found me. Hold on to this for me, will you, honey?
You mind? Sometimes I wish I couldn't read him so clear, but I saw it, same as you.
I'm not sure what I saw.
Yes, you are. Justin's really locked into it.
It? You mean that gun?
Revenge, woman. Looks like Justin may have to kill himself a man before he lets his daddy go in peace.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I mean, Justin wouldn't do that. Even with his temper, even as impulsive as he is. No, he wouldn't do that.
Lady, I know Jess. Knew him day in and day out all the time we were growing up together. We used to be like two fingers on the same hand. And he would.
No, he wouldn't. The trouble with you is you take all this cowboy stuff too seriously. Well, Justin is too cosmopolitan for that. He wouldn't shoot somebody.
I'm not asking you to believe me. I don't even care. You couldn't do anything about it anyway. Nobody could stop him if he was determined to do it. That's just the way he is. Why, if Justin made up his mind, the only way anybody could stop him would be to kill him first. You listen to me. It was a time, long time ago. Justin and I, we were just boys, young boys at that. And there was a coyote deviling the place, bringing down the calves. So Justin and I, we set to tracking him. He laid down a good trail at first. But we kept losing it, finding it, losing it again. Coyotes are smart. And this one knew he had trouble on his tail. So anyway, we tracked him for 3 days straight. Didn't stop it a few times for water. Wolfed down a handful of beef jerky. Just rolled and rolled.
You slept, didn't you?
Oh, I wanted to. Wanted to rest, at least. I mean, I was beat. So were the horses. And so was Justin. But he wouldn't admit it. Wouldn't give in to it, I should say. Kind of like a crazy man. Skin burning, his eyes red, just wouldn't stop. Said we could rest all we wanted to once we brought that coyote down. He said that coyote was made of meat just like we were. And all we had to do was outlast him by 5 minutes.
Well, what happened?
Well, we rode him down. And when we did, Justin put a 30-30 right between his eyes.
Hey, Elena, are you hurt? Come on. Hey, listen, you all right? Look, I was just kidding, you know? I didn't mean to. You got the worst damn luck. They see you like this, they're good. Elena. Come on, Elena, you all right? I didn't mean to do this. Come on, wait.
Oh, Lord! What happened?
Sir, thank you.
Now, when you take that piece of paper back to your uncle, I want you to tell him something for me. That's for my grandmother's sake. But you tell him. Nothing's changed between him and me.
Well, what's that mean? Am I supposed to understand what you're talking about?
No, I don't expect you to understand. It's just that Alex Wheeler's lived in Texas long enough to know what I mean. You just tell him what I said.
Boy, you've got no...
Grandma, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to be leaving.
Leaving? You are not leaving.
Yes, ma'am, I am. It's time for me to get back to Houston.
It's no such thing. Those burns, they need more time to heal upright.
Grandma, they didn't need as much time as I gave them. I used them for an excuse so that I could spend more time around my favorite lady. And to get a hold of this place again. To get the feeling. So that I'd know clearly why I was signing that agreement that gives Alex Wheeler title to my father's house.
And you know it clear now, boy.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, I know. It's just like what you said. This place is not just some chunk of hot Texas land. It hasn't been that for generations. It's where we're from. It's where we come home to sleep, like Daddy did.
You've almost got it right, boy. But this place is no cradle. And it's not just a grave, either. This is a place where folks can live in the way they were meant to live.
And they're never going to take it from us, Grandma. Not for 1,000 years. I gotta be leaving now.
Between the eyes, huh?
Smack dab.
Well, that was a coyote he killed. A vicious animal. It's not a man. It's not a human being. You're wrong about Justin, that's all.
Well, you think what you like. That'll help you to sleep any better.
You're wrong and smug at the same time. You know, I don't know where you get off being so all-fired sure of yourself, so self-righteous. You're not the great infallible judge of character that you think you are.
Maybe, but I do know Justin.
You are just like Kevin, just like him.
Yeah, who's Kevin?
My husband. You're as bullheaded as he is.
Yeah, and you say I'm like this fellow?
Just like him.
Well, that's really strange to hear. Sorry to see how there could be much likeness between me and a man who'd marry you.
So what do you mean by that?
I mean, it's just sort of hard for me to conjure up the kind of man who'd be blind and dumb enough to try to make a wife out of you.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah. Seems to me a man had more peace of mind alone in a lion shack with nothing but some old rattlers for companionship.
That's right, honey, huh? It's hard for you to imagine that I could be gratifying company. I mean, only if I wanted to.
Oh, no, no, I'll give you that. You're a flat-out beauty. You got plenty of spirit, too. But you got a head like a motor block. Near as I can tell, a heart of stone. I think it must have been the money that ruined you.
Ruined?
Yeah, you really could have been one incredible lady, but...
I am one incredible lady. Not that a dunce like you could see it.
Oh, you're smart as a whip. But you're trained all wrong, you know, bad-tempered.
All you know about is horses, and I ain't one of them, honey.
Well, that's too bad. There would have been some hope for you. Now, take a look at yourself. You've gotten by with jollying all the men in your life, haven't you? Now, you lay on all that sweetness and honey so thick until they can't live without you. And once you got them weak for you that way, out come the claws.
Stick to horses, honey.
You're one in a million. Honey, but I bet your husband pays more than that for his, privileges.
Cut it out! Cut it out! You're a lump! You're an ignorant country!
Oh, enough of the flattery. You're making me blush. You keep talking like that and people are going to start thinking there's something between us.
Oh, you are infuriating! You're impossible! I'll just never understand why Kate just doesn't fire you right off the place.
Well, that's simple. She keeps me around here to handle strange happenings and crazy ladies that wander out of the city like you.
Oh!
Hey, easy now with the haymaker practice, honey. You better save that when you get home to your hubby. Now, he's got to put up with it. Me? I hit back.
Well, I just signed the house over to Wheeler. Now it's time.
Time, honey?
Time to get down to it. Start collecting what Wheeler owes to me.
Elena? What on earth has happened to this child? Nina, well, get me some water, quick.
She fell down them steps.
Child? She fell, Billy Joe?
Yes, ma'am. What it was she was going up onto her room, and I don't know, I guess she was dizzy or something, and she fell, and then I heard her scream, and I came running over to help, and that's when you and Nina got back. I don't know what's happening. I just saw her lying there, just like that.
Oh, Elena. Elena. Wake up, Elena. Wake up.
Oh, how is she, Maggie?
I think she's coming around.
What happened?
She fell.
Oh, now, wait. Easy, baby. Easy. Now, just take it easy.
My head hurts.
Well, of course your head hurts, honey. You got a lump back there the size of Padre Island. You're going to be all right now. Just your stomach's not upset, is it?
No.
Oh, well, thank goodness for that. Now, will you please tell a worried old aunt just what happened?
I told you, Maggie. Elena fell. She got dizzy and fell down them steps. Isn't that right, Elena?
I heard what you said, Billy Joe. Is that what happened, Elena? Did you fall down the stairs?
Yes. Yes, that's what happened, Aunt Maggie. I fell down the step.
But how did you?
Well, I'm all right now that you're here. I feel better now that you're with me.
Well, honey, I want you to wait just a minute now and catch your breath and then let Billy Joe carry you upstairs.
No! No, no, I'm all right, Aunt Maggie.
Oh, honey, you are as weak as a kitten.
Well, maybe if you help me, I could
walk. Nita, give me a hand.
Sure.
Oh, I'd be glad to, honey.
I'm better now, Aunt Maggie.
I don't care, just the same. As soon as I get you tucked in bed, I'm going to call the doctor. Now, it might be all right, and it might not. You know what I'm thinking.
Well, I'm fine. Lay down.
I saw those two bottles of beer out, Little Joe.
So I had a couple beers. So what?
There were two glasses out.
I
noticed you were running over there to put them behind the bar. Well, I already did it for you, so Maggie wouldn't see. Because I don't want her to know.
Know what?
That you fed that little girl so much beer, she got all woozy and she tripped down those stairs.
Yeah. Yeah, well, she's all right. Now, I gotta get to work or I'll be late. I gotta get cracking. I'm gonna go upstairs and get dressed now, if you don't mind.
You think you can just run away from everything, don't you?
No, I don't just think I can run away from everything. As a matter of fact, I'm getting ready so I can run to work. I'm getting pretty tired of your tone, too, woman. I never get any sweet, soft voice from you. All I ever get is accused. You better learn to lighten up, honey, okay?
Billy Joe, this is serious. You shouldn't have done that.
What's so serious about it? So I gave her a few beers. The girl's 17 years old. Or maybe you don't remember when you were 17.
I remember, but...
I used to buy you beers all the time, and we used to go partying out half the night. And you used to get pretty woozy yourself, you know. You used to get pretty giggly, get to talking to me real soft. Yeah. Tell me again, hon. Did you like them days or didn't you?
I like them fine, Billy Joe, but that is not what we are talking about.
Well, whatever we were talking about, I gotta get ready for work. We don't have time to finish it. Not till later. I'm gonna go to work now.
I surely did enjoy those times, Billy Joe. But I never dreamed it would end up like this.
Dear sir, we are prepared to pay a very large sum for a very small act.
What small act, Your Excellency?
Shigzinti has informed me that the doctor, the operation Dr. Cook will perform will be to put in a pacemaker. Now, you would have access to such a device, would you not? All right. All you would have to do is replace the hospital's pacemaker with one which I will provide.
Why you want to switch the pacemaker?
Damn! I tape a government bigwig plotting to murder his king. I get him so dead to rights he's willing to make me rich to get hold of that tape. And Alex Wheeler can't stop treating me like a flunky long enough to go along with the deal. Well, I'm not gonna miss this chance, whatever I do. I ain't gonna blow this one. Yeah. Come in.
Stryker. Well, what was this big deal you were hinting about down the club?
All the oil and tank here, Stryker. It's mine to move anywhere in the world. It's got to go. I've got the exclusive transport rights for the asking.
Is that a fact? Huh. Well, how did you make it to the big leagues so fast from scratch?
This place, this club, I've made some pretty important contacts here.
Sounds like you have.
Well, my part's in the bag. Let's talk about yours. You interested? All I need is you to use your money and your contacts to help me set up a company to move that oil. Simple as that.
Simple, huh?
Piece of cake.
Tell me one thing. Why are you going about it the hard way? Why don't you go straight to Alex with your deal? He's got the money and the ships and more connections than I could make in 100 years.
I told you, I don't trust him.
But you didn't tell me why.
It's personal. I'd rather not go into the details.
Well, I would be more comfortable knowing some of those details, if you don't mind.
It's just that I know Alex better than you, probably better than anyone. And I know what he's capable of.
He is capable of building one of the greatest fortunes in the richest country on earth. Now, you don't do that by being a choir boy.
He can be very underhanded.
Oh, come on, Clipper. What'd you expect, Prince Valiant?
All right. All right, I'll give you an example if you want. I wouldn't trust any man who'd play around with another man's wife and pretend to be his good buddy all the time.
Now, that's pretty rough talk, son. You want to tell me what friend we are talking about and whose wife?
And now, the next part of Texas.
I just checked on that patient you helped me with.
Well, Ricky Decker, how's he doing?
Fine. Wonderful.
Good.
Bart says he's making a fast recovery thanks to you. You know, it makes me feel so strong and secure knowing you're there to help when I'm not certain.
You know, Courtney, you're advancing so rapidly and so strongly, one day soon you won't need my help anymore. You won't even think you do.
No. I'll always need your help. And your approval. And your love, Kevin, most of all. You're not withdrawing it, are you?
I couldn't do that if I wanted to. I'm not made of steel. I'm simply trying to control the situation.
As long as it's not remote control.
You know, I think about this in spite of myself, but one day you're going to be a very fine surgeon with a full life of your own. And, well, you'll remember me as having been one of your teachers, but you won't need me.
No, that's wrong. Even if I didn't need you as a teacher any longer, I'd still want you as my lover. My husband.
Now, Courtney, listen to me.
Please. Would it be so terribly unfair to Rena if we stole just an hour just for ourselves?
Yeah. Courtney, I'm not thinking about being unfair to Rena. I'm thinking about being unfair to you.
Me? I don't understand.
It's because you don't know Rena. She suspected the feelings we have for each other. She'd move heaven and earth to destroy you, see you humiliated, and to see to it that we never work together, ever again.
Kevin, she's just one person. What can she possibly do?
Well, I didn't know until recently. Now I found out just how far she can go. It was discovering a whole new side of Rena even I didn't know existed.
Why? What happened?
She had her mother followed by a private detective and then blackmailed her.
Blackmail?
So Vicky would let her stay here in Houston. You see, Vicky is guilty of an indiscretion. Rena threatened to tell Stryker.
But his heart condition. This could kill him,
yes,
my Lord.
I know. I tried to wake Rena up to that fact, but she ignored me. You see, that's Rena's way. She ignores or attacks anything she thinks will threaten her fantasy world. And Courtney, I'm not going to give her a chance to try her dirty work on you.
whose wife are we talking about?
Like I said, I'd rather keep the specifics to myself.
Now look, I don't want to play any games. If you got something to say, say it.
All right, your wife. Alex and Vicky have been having an affair that's probably gone on for years.
No, I don't believe you. You can't be right.
I know it's tough for you to accept, but as much as I hate to be the one to tell you, it's true, and there is no changing that.
Now, look. If you are so all-fired sure yourself, let me have some proof. Because that's the kind of a remark that's going to get a reaction out of me, son.
Proof? I don't...
That is my wife whose name you're throwing down in the mud. If you got proof, I want to hear it.
Well, I've seen her with Alex.
You make a filthy accusation out of that? That's nothing! They've been friends for years!
Well, I hear there are photographs to tell the story even better.
You heard? Why, I ought to... You got photographs, I want to see them.
Well, I don't keep them laying around the office.
You know what I think, Curtis? I think you are so desperate to cut this fool deal of yours, you will do anything to discredit Alex.
Yeah? Okay. I didn't want to make a production out of this, but
seeing as... Yeah, but you went and made a production, didn't you?
No! All I'd hoped was you'd be interested in the business deal, not in the reasons why I wouldn't trust it now in Sweeter. But if you want proof, that's what you're going to get. I guess it's your being a lawyer or something. Well, I'll give you proof that it passed muster at a murder trial. Not that I'm suggesting anything.
I won't hold my breath.
We'll see. When you take a look at the proof, we'll see what you have to say then.
I reckon I will worry when and if I have to.
No fractures, no internal injuries. Elena's gonna be good as new.
Thank the Lord.
I'd let her sleep if she wants. She's young and strong. That's probably all the medicine she'll need.
Well, what about the bump?
It's superficial. There's no evidence of a concussion. I don't see any need for x-rays.
Oh, that's a blessing. I don't know how to thank you, Bart, for coming over here and putting our minds at ease.
Oh, it's good practice for me. I plan to bring back the house call, you know. Besides, I was thinking of dropping by for supper anyway.
Well, tonight it's going to be on the house. Lord knows you have patched up enough Deckers this week. Oh, I haven't thanked you properly for taking care of Ricky yet.
Not at all.
Besides, I'm just so glad there was nothing serious wrong with Elena. I don't know what I would have said to Max. I promised him I'd look after her.
Well, Aunt Maggie, don't tell Max anything about what happened. Oh, Elena, let me help you. You're still weak.
Oh, I'm okay.
Come over here. Sit down. I just want to go home. Would you call Max and tell him I want to go home?
Elena, I think you'd better get a good night's sleep before you try to do anything.
That's right, honey.
No. No, I just want to go home now, please.
But I don't know why you want to go home tonight, baby.
I just want to. Will you call Max and tell him?
Well, Justin and Don have both signed now. So that's all the Marshall heirs.
But one. All we need now, Ginny, is your signature as Steve's guardian.
Kate, we've been through all this before. How can I sign that for Steve? He doesn't have the inheritance unless Barrett is declared dead. And I can't do that. I just can't. I won't.
I know how painful it is to you, Ginny, but... You don't have to do anything.
Then you won't be able to clear the ranch.
Yes, we will. Ryan explained something to me about my duties as administratrix of Mike's estate.
What?
That I can have my grandson declared legally dead, if that's the only way to clear the estate in the courts.
You can?
Yes.
I'll handle most of the details. I can request a certificate of presumed death from the Defense Department and then present it to the Texas court.
This is a conspiracy. You two have conspired to force me into signing that. I can't believe it.
Now, you shouldn't blame Ryan, Ginny. If you need someone to blame, you're looking straight at her.
Kate, why?
I want it done. I need it done. To clear the estate and save the ranch.
But this way?
I want it for another reason, Ginny. Maybe a more important reason. Much as it would hurt both you and me. I want you to stop waiting for Barrett Marshall to come walking back from the grave.
Kate, we don't know he's...
It's been too long, Ginny. And it's hurt you too much. I want you to start living again. I want you to bury your man once and for all. Ryan, go after her, son. See if you can't comfort her a little.
Pretty terrible thing to ask of you. But even though Kate's taking the responsibility, you know whose idea it was, right?
I know. But it doesn't matter. I don't care who wants it, who thinks that it should be done. I don't. Even if you and Kate go ahead with this legal business, it won't change anything, Ryan. And it certainly won't change the way I feel.
Well, I'd be disappointed if it did.
What do you mean?
Hey, you know, I'm not just a lawyer. I'm not just a man who cares for you and your family. I've been living in the same world you have, Ginny. I was in that war too, remember? Barrett and I, we may have crossed paths. Shared a drink out of the same bottle. So I know how you feel. And it's good. It's honorable. It's what love demands. I don't think I could understand you if you felt any other way.
Then why can't you...
Because I see so much life in you. Because I think you feel in your heart that this has been going on too long, like Kate said. That Barrett must really be gone.
No!
Not his spirit, and not your love for him, but the Barrett who always held you in his arms and kept you safe and warm. You know it, don't you? You know that your duty to him has ended, don't you? Why won't you admit it? Look, you've come to the end of your mourning. You just can't spend the rest of your life waiting for him to return when you know deep down he's not going to.
Ryan, I can't.
It's not going to be easy. It shouldn't be. It's always going to be a part of you waiting for him. While the rest of you goes on and has a happy life.
After all these years, I never even thought of being... happy unless he came home.
I know. It's like his dying never ended, right? And like you'd be cheating him if you ever felt any happiness, right? Well, that can't be forever.
If I lost him, I'd just feel lost if I let go of him.
Of course you would at first. What kind of woman would you be if you could easily turn around and forget that love you started with, huh? And what kind of man would I be if I wanted you to? You know what? You're gonna need a man to help fill up the emptiness in your life, you know? I want to be that man. Ginny?
Ginny? Ginny! Oh. There you are. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. Maggie called and said Elena's ready to come back home now.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, it is, especially since her school's starting up again. Well, anyway, I just wanted you to tell Kate that I wouldn't be in for supper. I'm going to drive in now and pick up Elena. I'm glad she got the city out of her system.
Okay, Max, I'll be sure and tell Kate.
Yeah. Thanks.
Well, looks as if there's going to be an empty place at the supper table.
Doggone, I knew it was in one of these pockets.
What's the matter? What'd you lose?
An old rain check. Now, I know I'm going to find it, so when I do, what, should I tear it up or cash it in?
It's much too valuable to tear it up.
Yeah, sure is valuable.
Ryan, I'd like it very much if you'd stay for supper.
Wonderful. Thank you. I'd love to stay. Very much.
Stay tuned for the conclusion of Texas.
How you doing there tonight, ladies? Enjoying everything?
How you feeling,
Elena? I'm okay. Maybe a little hungover. I wanted to tell you, I know what happened today.
You do?
I saw the beer bottles on the bar.
Well, Billy Joe...
I know it wasn't your fault getting tipsy like that. It was wrong for Billy Joe to give them to you and then have you falling down the stairs like that. I'm so ashamed of him giving you beers like that. I mean, I want him so bad just to act right. But sometimes he just doesn't have any good sense. I hope you won't go telling your folks. I know me and him would get in trouble with Maggie if you did. I need this job.
I wouldn't say anything to anybody. You've been good to me, and I don't want to get you in any trouble.
Oh, sweetie, thank you. Thanks a lot. Well, now there's your big brother.
Well, I'm off to work. See you around, kiddo.
So you had enough of the big city? Ready to come home and breathe some clean air now?
Oh, yes. Oh, I can't wait to go home, Max. I just want to go home.
Okay. Let's go.
Thank you. Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
That what it's like to be a